Hi Omies, I'm Simquoya, and we are currently chatting with Roger and Mallory, Rosie's mother, or now she's known as Nasima. She has changed her name, and basically, Roger has trekked his way to Selvadorada looking for Mallory. And he was asking some locals around, you know, showing them her photo, asking them, like, have you seen this woman? Her name is Mallory. Have you seen her? Have you seen her? And everybody said no until he met the guy at the bar who was like, actually, yeah, I know her, but her name's not Mallory. It's Nasima. You know, she owns the art gallery studio space, you know, down the little street walkway thing. And so Roger came here to check it out. And when he did, he, of course, saw her. And was quite shocked because he hasn't seen her in a very long time. And as you can see, Mallory is very disturbed by his presence being here, completely caught off guard. Roger is basically talking to her and telling her, like, you know, I think I deserve some answers. You've been gone for so long. You've never called. You never wrote a letter or sent an email or anything. You know, he told her that he hired a private investigator, and she's over here like, a private investigator? Really? Like, why couldn't you just let me go? And so Roger is telling her, like, Lori, I still love you. And Lori is like, no, I want you to move on. Like, you really need to move on. And Roger's just like, I can't, you know, he's like, I can't move on without at least knowing why. Like, in Roger's mind, that was his soulmate. Everything was perfect, you know, and her getting pregnant to have Rosie would have made them a perfect little family. So what went wrong? And so Mallory is about to tell him what went wrong. So Roger is pretty much telling Lori, like, I can't move on, you know, I need answers, I need to know why I came all this way, you can at least tell me the truth. And so Lori is telling him that she just was not in a good place mentally, which he knows, you know, she has some postpartum depression, if you guys remember from the previous episode. And, well, not the previous episode, but in the episode where we talked about Rosie's mother and, you know, her leaving and everything like that. So she's letting him know that she wasn't in a good place mentally, and she actually never wanted to be a mother. Her childhood was really rough, and when she got pregnant, Roger was so excited to become a dad and have a family. Like, she didn't want to let him down, but it was way too much pressure on her. So once Rosie was born, she felt like she had no choice but to just leave Rosie with Roger. And so Roger is telling her, like, you should have told me, we could have figured something else out, you know, and got you the help that you needed. She's just like, no, like, that's in the past and I'm happy now. And he's basically asking, like, so that's it, we're just gonna pretend like we never happened, like us never happened. Lori's like, well, I mean, you know, you got what you wanted out of it, you got a daughter, you know, how is she doing? And Roger's like, are you serious, Lori? Like, she needs her mother in her life. And he's just telling her about how every Mother's Day for the past, like, 23 years that he's been Rosie's shoulder to cry on. And so he's telling her, like, you know, maybe for her birthday this year, I won't have to do that. Oh no, and it's starting to rain. So yeah, so she's kind of upset, like, no, like, I don't want to meet her. I don't want to come back into her life like that. I think it's best if I stay away. Oh gosh, these Selvadorada mosquitoes. Their conversation is coming to a close. Okay, so when Roger first got to their store, or Lori's store, he was looking at the paintings and he happened to meet the artist right here. The artist is Kaya, I think that's her name, I gotta check. Anyway, she just came outside because she has some news for Lori. So she just came outside like, Mom, somebody's interested in a commission. Do you see her face? Do you see his face? Kaya is Lori's daughter. And she's about 16, she's a teenager. And so now Roger has even more questions. So she's sitting here kind of like, okay, honey, like, I'll be inside in just a second. Like, you know, just tell them I'll be right there. I'm wrapping up right now. Lori is all types of devastated about this whole entire occurrence right now. And Roger just doesn't know how to feel. Oh, look at him. He just is leaving. I really thought that he was going to, like, talk to her and ask her questions like, wait, so you have a daughter? You have a daughter whose life you're in. You just told me you don't want to be in your first daughter's life. But here you are running an art store with her. And he hasn't even told her about how Rosie is into art as well, and how she's probably inherited her artistic abilities from her mother. It's just a lot going on. So I imagine that Roger is just going to come in here really quickly and leave Rosie's business card and information so that Laurie can reach out to her when she gets ready to. He doesn't know what else to do. He is shocked that Laurie has a daughter now, that she is involved in her life. I don't see where she went. Laurie went into the bathroom, probably to get away from Roger. It's a very unfortunate time right now, and Roger is just ready to go home, back to Newcrest. Poor Roger. This is not what he thought he was going to get when he came here, which honestly, he couldn't have thought he was going to get anything good, but he didn't think he was going to get this. Okay, so Roger is back from Selvadorada. He came home early. He only bought a one-way ticket because he didn't know how long it would take for him to get the information he needed, which was finding Laurie. And so he found her and got the very unsettling news about everything. And so now he's home and he is very depressed, as anybody in his situation would be. So he came home and he's pretty much just staying here, crying it out in the bed, sleeping. When he did get home though, another thing that has added to his sadness is that Laurie did contact him. She sent him an email. She saw the card that he left. And so she sent him an email because she did feel like she owed him an explanation about Kaya, which is her daughter. So basically, we know from previous episodes that in the episode where we found out that Roger hired a private investigator, Laurie, her last known whereabouts was about 16 years ago when she got that one-way ticket to Selvadorada. And the private investigator said, like, you know, she's probably changed her name. She's probably starting over, like, a new life. And that's exactly what she did. She moved to Selvadorada and she changed her name. She changed her name to Nasima, which is Arabic for fresh air. And once she got there, she actually got pregnant again. And so with her moving and after dealing with, you know, the mental stress of her postpartum depression and leaving Roger and Rosie in the way she did, she really wanted to be in this new place and start fresh. And so she was having a child. She changed her name. So she's like, you know what? This is going to be my opportunity to try again. So she did feel bad about what she did, but she felt like, okay, maybe I can right my wrong by, you know, staying with this child and raising this child and doing the best by this child. So she named her Kaya, which I found is Indian for new beginning. So Kaya is like her new beginning, her fresh start. So she stayed in Selvadorada. She stopped moving around. She didn't leave her. Her and the dad didn't work out. You know, she pretty much got pregnant and raised Kaya all by herself, which is crazy because Roger has raised Rosie all by himself. But yeah, so she sent Roger an email just kind of explaining that, like, you know, I felt like I could do good finally, you know, by keeping this child and, you know, being as good of a mother as I can be. And she's like, I hate that you had to find out. I hate you had to find out this way. And she's still letting him know, like, she doesn't know if she can face Rosie. Like, she's just not sure. So she's kind of leaving the ball in his court on what he's going to do. Like, is he going to tell her that he saw her and met her? Because she already said, like, if you tell Rosie that you saw me, and if she calls me, I can't tell you that I'm ready to talk to her. So Roger is stressed, he's depressed, he's shocked. Rosie is gonna want him to, like, go on dates soon. And so, like, basically at the time of him going on this trip and coming back home, Rosie was in Sulani for her birthday trip that he got her, which he only got her that to get her away from him, far away from him, so that he can go to Selvadorada and do what he just did. So at this time, he's just like trying to figure it all out. Like, what am I going to do? When she gets back from her trip, she's gonna want me to go on these dates and act like everything is normal. Like, how can I act like anything is normal with all of this information that I've gotten? Like, Roger really just dug himself into a really deep hole that he probably should have avoided. What do you guys think? Do you guys think he should have been searching? Like, do you think that he, like, what do you think? Did he set himself up for failure by looking for all this and now he has all this information? Like, he saw the love of his life finally after like 20 something years and she wanted nothing to do with him or Rosie. Like, talk about upsetting. Rosie is a big sister. Who knew? Her mom and her sister are artists as well. Like, in a perfect world, they would all get along great. But with the way everything has happened, I just don't know that they'll ever get the opportunity. And this is something really big. Like, you guys know, Rosie and Roger are best friends. Like, they're best friends. Rosie loves her dad. Roger loves Rosie. They're two peas in a pod. This is huge for him to keep from Rosie. So he really just doesn't know what to do. He doesn't know what to do. He knows if he tells her, she's going to be upset. But he knows if he doesn't tell her that, I mean, either way, I don't think it's going to be good, like, regardless of what he chooses to do. But the fact that he already went to Selvadorada and didn't tell her he was going, especially for this reason, I just don't see it. I just don't see it going well, period. So he might as well tell her, because either way, it's going to be bad, in my opinion. See, he can't even finish his food. Aw, Roger. Ooh, you guys, let me know your thoughts. Let me know, do you think it was a good idea for Roger to go to Selvadorada? What do you think about Lori's reasoning for, you know, just not wanting to be a mother and just not being able to handle the pressure? And it's crazy, you know, she didn't really want to disappoint anybody, but she knew she was going to by leaving and everything. But anyway, what do you think about that? What do you think about her, you know, being a mom to this other child, Rosie being a big sister, and Roger having to hold all this information in by himself? Like, that's a lot on one person. Let me know what you guys think. Happy holidays. This video will be going out right before the holidays. And yeah, the next segment of this mini series is going to be Sage. And woo child, it's a lot going on in Sage's story. A lot. I don't even know what I'm going to do in that video yet. But you guys can catch up with everything from what's been going on with Sage on my Tumblr. Her story is called Sage's Shot. And yeah, that's going on every day on my Tumblr. So you can catch up with Sage before I put the video out. But after that video comes out right in the new year, we will have season 2 of Rosie in the City. And I'm really excited about that. I guess we can stop looking at Roger's chili or whatever he was eating. Go ahead, watch your Golden Girls and try to cheer up, Roger. Try to cheer up. Oh no, he said forget Golden Girls. Oh yeah, go in your plant room, your little sanctuary. Oh! He said, I'm getting a drink. F this. Oh, Roger. Wow. Okay, but yeah. So you guys let me know in the comments your thoughts. Subscribe if you haven't already. Catch up on anything that you've missed in season 1 before season 2 gets started. And like this video, you know, if you were here for Roger's shenanigans in Selvadorada. Ooh, should that be the title? Roger's shenanigans in Selvadorada? Anyway, I'll chat with you guys later. Peace.